रिविजन ऑफ 11th स्टैंडर्ड ट्रिगोनोमेट्री। देर वेर थ्री चैप्टर्स इन योर पेपर वन ऑन ट्रिगोनोमेट्री। द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वॉज एंगल एंड इट्स मेजरमेंट। हियर यू स्टडीड टर्म्स लाइक डायरेक्टेड एंगल्स, कोटर्मिनल एंगल्स एंड सो ऑन। बट द मेन कॉन्सेप्ट वॉज दैट ऑफ अ न्यू सिस्टम टू मेजर द एंगल एंड दैट वॉज द रेडियन मेजर। सो हाउ डिड यू डिफाइन वन रेडियन? फॉर दैट यू कंसिडर्ड अ सर्कल ऑफ आर्बिट्ररी रेडियस और एनी रैंडम रेडियस। लेट अस टेक द रेडियस एज आर। ओके, लेट द सेंटर बी एट सी, लेट दिस पॉइंट बी ए। नाउ यू नो दैट सर्कमफरेंस ऑफ द सर्कल इज 2πr और लेंथ ऑफ द ब्लू शेप्ड कर्व। इफ यू पिक सम अदर पॉइंट बी ऑन द सेम सर्कल सच दैट लेंथ ऑफ आर्क ए बी इज इक्वल टू द रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल, देन द एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय द आर्क ए बी एट द सेंटर इज इक्वल टू 1 radian। ओके, सो लेंथ ऑफ सेगमेंट सी ए, लेंथ ऑफ सेगमेंट सी बी इज इक्वल टू लेंथ ऑफ आर्क ए बी। इफ दैट इज ट्रू, देन दिस एंगल सबटेंडेड इज इक्वल टू 1 radian। द फुल सर्कल सबटेंड्स एन एंगल ऑफ 2π radians, करेक्ट? यू नो दैट, एंड 2π radians इज 360 degrees। And from this relation, pi radians is 180 degrees. 1 radian equal to 180 divided by pi degrees, which is approximately 57 degrees. And pi by 180 radians is 1 degree. And all other relations for 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees and 270 degrees. Okay, the other concept that we will need from the first chapter is the coterminal angles. Okay, now what are coterminal angles? Coterminal angles are those angles whose measures differ by integral multiples of 2π. So theta, theta plus 2π, theta plus 4π and so on, and also theta minus 2π, theta minus 4π and so on. Now, where are these 2π, 4π coming from? We observe that 2π is actually equivalent to one full revolution. Okay, so if this is our angle theta measured in the anticlockwise direction, then if we complete one full revolution in anticlockwise direction and then again go to this, the initial and the terminal arms of the angle are same. Okay, but the amount of rotation or the measure of the angle is different. Okay, now it has become theta plus 2π. So these two are coterminal angles which share the same initial arm and the terminal arm. Same with theta plus 4π, theta minus 2π. Ata theta minus 2π lagaya hota, you actually complete the rotation in clockwise direction and then you go to this angle, okay, or this ray in anticlockwise direction. Convention ka hai, anticlockwise positive, clockwise negative. That is why theta positive and 2π negative. Then the other two formulas were length of arc and area of sector. Again, we consider an arc of a circle whose radius is r. If the angle subtended by the arc PQ at the center is theta in radians, not in degrees, then length of arc PQ is given by r theta. Okay, and area of the sector CPQ is given by 1 by 2 r squared theta. Let me highlight the area in white color now. Okay, so this sector is like piece of pizza. larger the angle subtended at the center, more the amount that you will get to eat. The third formula is perimeter of sector. And the perimeter of the sector is equal to R, which is length of CP, plus R theta, which is length of arc PQ, again plus R, which is length of QC. So you can take R common, it will be 2 plus theta. That is the perimeter of the sector. Now, although we are not going to use the formula for length of arc and area of sector in at least 12th standard trigonometry, let me tell you that we are going to have a chapter on applications of definite integrals. This is a chapter in paper 2. Okay. Here we are going to learn integration as a tool to find area. Okay. Now, currently we are aware of areas of few simple figures like circle, rectangle, then maybe parallelogram and so on, square, triangle. But if I give you any random figure, for example, let us consider the parabola y equal to x square. Okay. And if I say what is the area bounded by this parabola? This much. So can you come up with the exact representation or exact value of this area if the equation of the parabola is y equal to x squared? Then you cannot find it by using these formulas which you have currently. So you have to use integration there. Okay. And even the area of the sector formula, which is 1 by 2 r squared theta, this can also be obtained with the help of integration. I don't know whether you are aware of this. Derivative of x squared is 2x. Okay. So, derivative of x squared by 2 is x. Therefore, integral of x will be x squared by 2. Because differentiation and integration are complementary. So, जर तुम्ही x squared by 2 चा derivative काढताय आणि म्हणताय x आहे, तर x चा integration काय होणार आहे? परत येणार आहे x squared by 2. And now look at this formula. If you integrate r, what will you get? You will get r squared by 2. आणि हे जे r squared by 2 आहे, हेच इथे येत आहे. R squared by 2. Okay, so all these things are connected to each other. So we will revisit the area problem in integration. Now the last topic from the first chapter is angle between hands of a clock. We seldom consider the second hand, but we are more interested in the minute hand and the hour hand. So let us derive the expressions for angular velocity or velocities for all of them. Omega. If you have studied circular motion, then you should be very well aware of what angular velocity is. And usually the unit of angular velocity is radian per second or revolutions per second, but it can also be or RPM. But it can also be degrees per second. Okay. Let us start with the second hand. What does the observation tell us? The observation tells us that second hand covers 360 degrees in 1 minute. Yes. So, what will the angular velocity be? It will be 360 degrees in 60 seconds. Correct? That is 6 degrees per second. Then let us go to minute hand. Now, minute hand covers 360 degrees in 60 minutes. Yes, because if it is currently 1 p.m., at the time of 2 p.m., the minute hand would have covered one full revolution in 1 hour or 60 minutes. So, what will the angular velocity be? 360 degrees divided by 60 minutes or 3600 seconds. So, how much is the angular velocity of the minute hand? It will be 1/10 of a degree per second. Yes. Finally, let us go to our hand. Now, in our hand, we have the following. Let us say our time is 3 p.m. or 4 p.m. Okay? And in 1 hour, the hour hand would have moved from 4 to 5. Yes. Now, in the clock, the full angle of 360 degrees is divided into 12 equal parts. 12 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and so on. 360 upon 12 is 30, which means the hour hand is covering an angle of 30 degrees in 60 minutes. So, what will the angular velocity be? 30 degrees in 3600 seconds, because 60 minutes are equivalent to 3600 seconds. So, this will be equal to 1 upon 120 degrees per second. So, these are the three angular velocities of three different hands of a clock. And based on this, you can find angle between the minute hand and hour hand at any given time.